See, say, Poland. Yes, we can. That became the rallying cry of Cesar Chavez a couple decades ago as he rallied Latino workers, farm workers, improved conditions from just horribly, horribly bad conditions. You know, there was a time when Cesar was on the headlines of every newspaper in the country. But nowadays, kids don't know who he is. And he's a hero to many. So a number of people in Ketchum today have established a Cesar Chavez Day and honoring him in hopes of educating everyone about who he was, what he stands for, and what he can teach us today.
Hello there. My name once again is Herbert Romero. Put together this incredible event, Hailing Cesar, honoring and showing tribute to Cesar Chavez once again with the partnership with Tammy Davis. Why? Well, believe it or not, I learned about Chavez a little bit kind of in my mid-ages. Not when I was young, not when I was a teenager, not when I was in high school. It was really around when I was 23 years old. And sad but true, it was when he passed away. My mentor took me to Delano from LA. We rode to Delano, California, to experience the wake and the funeral. And me being there and seeing how many people came, on record was around like 40,000 people, and I was one of them. I was one of those 40,000. Really, really impacted my life to the point that since then I've been following him. And in LA, it's very common that every year something's done to continue the legacy of Cesar Chavez. And then this year, I talked to different colleagues of mine, and I said, this is the time to bring it to the community, not just to a classroom or in the textbook, but to the actual community. And I'm very grateful that the library, the spot, Ayanson Valley, the Perrona radio station, the weekly responded. And now we have this community-wide, Blaine County Valley-wide response. And we're going to be tomorrow at Twin Falls. So we wanted to share the gift of Cesar Chavez, and we're going to be with CSI. And I'm very grateful for Alejandra and the Hispanic Chamber that responded, and they helped me organize for tomorrow's event. So we're here today, and we're very thankful, and Chavez will continue. Chavez, Cesar Chavez, brought people together of diverse communities, diverse cultures. Not only that, he was a grassroots organizer, and he was about policy change. He didn't just protest. He literally negotiated. You know, he knew how to wheel and deal. And in that era, that was a big deal. And I think we need to know how to do that more, how to negotiate, how to compromise, how to work together. And that is something that we really need to advocate, you know, in our communities and in our different neighborhoods. How to talk, how to sit down in the table and agree to disagree. And that's what Cesar Chavez did. And he was able to move, and he was still grassroots.
My name is John Zender Estrada, and I am a muralist from the city of Los Angeles and been painting murals since 1982 in Los Angeles. And what we have here behind me is a study for a painting of a mural that is still in existence in East Los Angeles. The mural was commissioned by the Cesar Chavez Foundation to educate the community about who Cesar Chavez was and what legacies he was bringing to different diverse communities. So from the image that we see behind me, this is a study which shows Cesar Chavez as the light bearer or the bringer of light to a darkened, you know, community or a darkened environment. In his case, he brought light to the farm workers and brought justice because a lot of farm workers were being exposed to pesticides, chemicals that were used, and they were having birth defects, cancer, things like that. So he really wanted to change the environment. He wanted to make things safer for the food, especially for the food industry. These are things that we want to, the FDA, whatever it's called, to try to improve the quality of the food, quality of the work. So he was a big advocate for controlling the environment, of keeping it safe. The other thing about Cesar Chavez was the idea of working hard, and the slogan that's really familiar with him is "Yes, we can," or "Sí se puede," and that concept is where it now transcends from just a farmer or working for the rights of farmer for any social injustice or anything that obstacle is in anybody's path. As we know, Obama used a lot of the "Yes, we can" campaign. And other candidates, which definitely means together as a unity, as a people, we can make a difference, we can change. So that's why here we have him again holding that candle. And the candle to me is also symbolic to wisdom, symbolic to not just light, but symbolic to almost like when someone has a memorial or someone shows a candlelight vigil, to those that have struggled in the past, remembering their struggle. In the very top is a eagle that is the Cesar Chavez eagle merged with the Aztec eagle with the serpent. That image, it was originally painted in San Diego in what's called Chicano Park. It is a huge mural there in San Diego that had that image there by itself. So I borrowed that image and included it in the mural. So to include also to open the border to all the way to San Diego, all the way up to Northern California. The grapes have the little skulls in them, which represent the pestilence in the grapes. In the 1970s, Cesar Chavez was protesting Gallo wine and did a series of boycotts, telling people not to purchase the wine. The blood in his hand is a symbol for the red wine, that when you squeeze the grape, it pours red wine. But it's also symbolic for the blood of the peoples who died from the pestilences in the fields of the farm workers.